Respected judges, lecturers and my dear friends, very good afternoon, and we are here to present our project on monsoon influence on malaria distribution and prevention measures. The aim of this project is to make people realize that the lack of sanitation is the main cause for the spread of this malaria disease. To create awareness among the common people on prevention, control and improving treatment seeking behavior. Coming to the objectives, the first objective is collection of data from different government hospitals like Nallagunta, Puranapul, Boduppal and Gachibowli using a questionnaire method. And the second objective is analyzing the collected data for the cause of occurrence and spread of this malaria disease. And the third objective is creating awareness among the common people and in colleges too. Now my friend Shruti will continue with the review of literature. Review of literature. Malaria is distributed among tropical, subtropical and monsoon zones of the world. According to the latest World Malaria Report, these were the figures of positive malaria cases and the death reports in the respective years. As per UNICEF report in the 2011, 90% of child deaths from malaria are due to contaminated water, lack of sanitation and poor hygienic conditions. What is malaria? As we all are aware of malaria and some of us also experienced it, it is a digenetic parasitic disease caused by plasmodium parasite and transmitted through mosquito, which affects the red blood cells of human. Due to congestion and sanitation issues, the positive malaria cases in the area are increasing year after year, especially in vulnerable and slum areas of the city. Sir Ronald Ross discovered the oocyst of plasmodium in the stomach wall of mosquito. The life cycle of plasmodium involves two hosts. As an infected mosquito bites the person, the effective sporozoites will enter into the liver cells and form the first generation cryptozoites. The first generation cryptozoites may have two options. They may enter into the fresh liver cells again or else enter into the bloodstream. When they enter into the bloodstream, they form the second generation merozoites. They are of two types, micrometa cryptozoites and micrometacryptozoites. The micrometacryptozoites always enter into the liver cells and the micrometacryptozoites will enter into the blood and further it forms the gametocytes and releases the hemozoin, which causes chill fever. Now my friend will continue with research methodology.
Research methodology. Under the limits of GHMC, we have selected four areas for recording malaria cases. They are Puranapul, Boduppal, Gachibowli and Nallagunta. And we used questionnaire methodology for our study purpose and the study area. We selected these areas based upon the sanitary conditions and we wanted to create awareness among the people about malaria. Whereas Gachibowli is financially well-developed area where sanitation conditions are maintained at high level. Whereas Boduppal and Puranapul are affected by the discharge from Musi River and they are highly polluted. Next, Pure Hospital in Telangana is highly popular to treat tropical and communicable diseases. And the main purpose of choosing Pure Hospital is to understand the impact of malaria at high level. Below figure represent the hospital areas chosen in Hyderabad. Study period. We studied these malaria cases for 5 successive months, June 2019 to October 2019. As it is a rainy season, which is favorable for mosquito breeding. And the number of malaria cases were identified by examining the blood smear microscopically. Twice a month we visited the selected hospitals to get the data of malaria registered cases. And every month end, we segregated the collected data and further analyzed it. This is the figure of our sample questionnaire. Now my friend Chandana will continue with analysis of data.
Now coming to analysis of data, as my friend told about the study area and study period, they have analyzed the data by dividing it into three different age groups, below 20, between 20 and 40, above 40. Every month we have visited the mentioned hospitals to collect the details of positive registered malaria cases. Many patients have visited or admitted in the hospitals with many reasons, but out of which we have considered only the positive registered malaria cases. Now coming to Nallagunta Fever Hospital, during our study period, thousands of patients have visited the hospital with malarial symptoms, out of which 118 cases have turned out to be positive. Out of 118 positive registered malaria cases, these are the figures that we got after dividing them into their age groups. And these are the pictures collected by us in the hospital and in the respective area. And this is the data collected by us in the hospital showing a study period from June to October 2019 and the respective age groups and our findings coming to a total of 118. Now coming to Puranapul Urban Primary Health Center, during our study period, 200 patients have visited the hospital with malarial symptoms, out of which 53 cases have turned out to be positive. Out of 53 positive registered malaria cases, these are the figures that we got after dividing them into their age groups. And these are the pictures collected by us in the hospital and in the respective area. and this is the data collected by us as mentioned earlier. Now coming to Godukpal Urban Primary Health Center, during our study period, 230 patients have visited the hospital with malarial symptoms, out of which 39 cases have turned out to be positive. Out of 39 positive registered malaria cases, these are the figures that we got after dividing them into their age groups. And these are the pictures collected in the hospital and in the respective area. And this is the data collected by us in the hospital as mentioned earlier. Now coming to Gachibowli Urban Primary Health Center, during our study period, 20 patients have visited the hospital with malarial symptoms, out of which 4 cases have turned out to be positive. Out of 4 positive registered malaria cases, these are the figures that we got after dividing them into their age groups. We have noticed less number of malaria cases here because this area is maintained well with good sanitation. And these are the pictures collected in the hospital and in the respective area. And this is the data collected in the hospital as mentioned earlier. And this is the overall report. And this is the overall report of our collected data showing our 4 study areas and our study period from June to October 2019 and the reported positive malaria cases in the respective age groups. And this is a graphical representation of our overall collected data showing 4 different hospitals and 3 different age groups. As we can see here, Nallagunta is having high number of malaria cases compared with Gachibowli. It is having less number of malaria cases. Now my friend will continue with findings and conclusions.
Well, coming to the findings and conclusion, as we all know, malaria is an acute febrile illness. In a non-immune individual, symptoms usually appear 10 to 15 days after an infective mosquito bite. The usually the symptoms like fever, headache, chills, and nausea and mild, difficult to recognize malaria. If not treated properly, it will lead to severe illness and may cause death. So, according to our result, the most affected age groups are below 20 years and above 40 years. The number of people affected by malaria seems to be rising in the city year after year due to congestion, overcrowding and sanitation problems. So the climatic factors like monsoon, which plays an important role in the spreading of malaria, whereas seasons like summer, it's not favorable for the spreading of malaria. So poor knowledge about malaria is a cause of poor treatment seeking behavior. Thus we need to promote awareness about early diagnosis and appropriate treatment and address the misconceptions about the spreading of malaria. So finally, we can conclude that the health conditions are prone to disease passenger, that is always related to lack of sanitation conditions and poor hygiene problems. So Sedji Datta headed a committee, they were invented a second generation vaccine which works 10 times better than the existing one, which is RTS-S vaccine. So these are the pictures we have collected during the awareness program conducted by us to the student. This is to the common people. Now my friend Savinisri will complete this presentation with suggestions.
As my friend told about the cause and spread of malaria, these are few suggestions to prevent malaria. We highly recommend the people to obey the guidelines issued by Government of Telangana and JHMC to maintain good and healthy surroundings so that we can prevent vector-borne diseases like malaria. WHO also coordinates sanitation actions with partners in other health initiatives such as neglected tropical diseases, cholera, nutrition, infection prevention and control, and antimicrobial resistance. As per the guidelines from Telangana government and GHMC, these are few recommendations to prevent malaria. Apply mosquito repellent to exposed skin. Wear long sleeve clothes which cover your arms and legs completely. Use mosquito net over your bed. Screen your doors and windows. Use mosquito repellent on clothing. Spray pyrethrin or similar insecticide in your bedroom. Next, consult doctor if you observe any symptoms. Our continued efforts in a sustained manner would lead to a clean, healthy, powerful and strong cities as well as New India. We are extremely thankful to the Honorable CC, our college principal Dr. DSR Rajendra Singh sir, and to our supervisor Dr. Shyam Sundar sir for giving this wonderful opportunity. Thank you.
GDC Karimnagar.
My question is, in fear hospital, approximately 3,000 patients with malaria symptoms, right? And only 3,000 patients are enrolled with malaria symptoms, not with malaria. Only there are 118 malaria positive. And what about the other patients?
They are negative.
Negative. Because the symptoms are flu-like symptoms, or any fever-like symptoms. So what the doctors told, whether this is other people,
during our study period, dengue is in మన అంటే మేము చేసిన స్టడీ పీరియడ్లో డెంగ్యూ అనేది చాలా ఎక్కువగా వ్యాప్తి చెందుతుంది సార్. అప్పుడు అయితే సేమ్ సింప్టమ్స్ ఉండడం వల్ల వాళ్ళు కూడా అసెస్ అయ్యేసరికి అందులో కొన్ని కేసెస్ మాత్రమే మలేరియా కేసెస్, మిగతావి చాలా వరకు డెంగ్యూ కేసెస్.
Good. Thank you so much.